Enjoy yourself. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Tonight Show. You're here. You made it. Thank you for watching at home. Well, guys, the Democratic National Convention is still going strong, and everyone is still buzzing about Michelle Obama roasting Trump last night, and then Barack Obama coming out and doing the same thing. Everyone there loved it. There was so much electricity in the arena, the whole crowd looked like Bernie Sanders. And it was... I'm so excited! And I just can't hide it. Yeah, Michelle and Barack really roasted Trump. It got even worse tonight because the speakers were Nikki Glaser, Tom Brady, and Jeff Ross. That was it, yeah. It was hot tonight, yeah. One of the big moments everyone's talking about is when Michelle called out Trump for repeatedly using the phrase black jobs. Watch this.
I want to know, who's going to tell him, who's going to tell him that the job he's currently seeking might just be one of those black jobs?
Wow, yeah. The last time... The last time Trump got burned that badly, he locked himself in his tanning bed. He was like, oh, but somebody get me out. Somebody get me out. Where's the escape button? It's unbroiled. It's unbroiled. And I'm smelling myself cooking. It's not good. It was the first time Trump was like, that's enough TV. I'm going to go exercise or read a book. Meanwhile, in his speech, Barack Obama urged Americans to reject the bumbling and chaos of a second Trump term, saying we've all seen that movie before and we know that the sequel is usually worse. Yep, Obama said sequels are usually worse. Then Trump looked at Don Jr. and said, touche. Oh, and did you guys see this? Obama also took a shot at Trump over his fixation on size. Yeah. Take a look at this.
There's the childish nicknames. The crazy conspiracy theories. This weird obsession with crowd sizes.
Hey!
And then Stormy Daniels said, nothing to fact check there. No. Of course, not everyone approved of Obama making a joke about the size of Trump's crowds. Check out what some lawmakers had to say. House Speaker Mike Johnson said, I didn't think joking about that was very funny.
Uh-oh.
Then Senator Ron Johnson said, neither did I. Then Congressman Hank Johnson said, me neither. Then Congressman Dusty Johnson said, I really didn't like it. And Congressman Josh Harder said, innuendo can be painful for some people. And Senator Gary Peters, Governor Spencer Cox, and Secretary Tom Vilsack said, we completely agree. Then Congresswoman Debbie Dingell said, you can add my name to the list. And finally, Congressman Dick Small said, I didn't have a problem with it. Never mind. That was that bad. That was pretty good. I think it's funny. I like that joke. Some more big political news. I read that RFK Jr. is planning on dropping out of the race and will likely endorse Trump. Trump heard and was like, if you really want to help me, you'll endorse Kamala. Kennedy's campaign said that he will address the nation on Friday to discuss his path forward. Address the nation?
Yeah.
Just say post a TikTok. Yeah. Come on. I mean, address the nation. And finally, this is going viral. Trump went on comedian Theo Vaughn's podcast, and Vaughn educated Trump on the effects of cocaine. Trump was like, yeah, this is all news to me. I don't know what it is. We have a great show. Give it up for The Roots, everybody! What a show we have for you tonight. She's a talented actress who stars in the new film Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, which is in theaters and IMAX September 6th. Jenna Ortega is here!
She's great.
Maybe a surprise guest, too. Plus, he stars in the new movie Between the Temples, which is out this Friday in theaters. One of my favorites, Jason Schwartzman, is joining us. Love that dude.
And we got great, great music from Thomas Rhett. Oh, yeah!
Look at that. Ooh. Gold record. A nice gold record, I think. Guys, I've been obsessed with the New York Times games lately. I love all the... I love, of course, the New York Times is great, too, but the games
they are used
fun.
To
yeah, I Connections. You guys know that game? Yeah. I got... But the day got away from me, and I haven't done today's puzzle, so I was thinking we could all maybe just do it together. It's time for tonight's show, Connections. Here we go. All right, so the way it works is that there are 16 random words or phrases, and our goal is to find four groups of four words that share a common theme. Once we think we have one, I'll click submit and see if we're right. Higgins, you see anything?
I think I do. I see sus, cap, bussin', and riz.
All right, and what's the connection?
Like they're like current slang words?
Yeah, that's good. All right, let's see if that's correct. Popular baby names.
Not popular, slang words.
Popular baby names in 2040. Right. Oh, yeah. Yeah. But it still was a match, so that counts.
2040, okay.
Yes, yes, yes. Quest, you have one?
Yeah, I think so. We got go fish, risk, trouble, and sorry.
Oh, yeah. Those are...
Popular games?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I see that. Let's try this. No, they're the stages of eating gas station sushi. Risk, trouble, and sorry again.
Yeah, yeah.
That was very lucky, both of those.
Yes. And then
connections
stars.
For yeah. different reasons.
Gas station get. Sushi.
What? Shrink, what? What do you, what?
I want to try.
Oh. Yeah, I guess everyone can play, I guess. Sure, if you got one, what do you see?
Okay, let's go. Dude, where's my car?
Uh-huh.
Don't tell mom the babysitter's dead.
Correct.
And, there will be blood. Oh, and... Get Out.
Oh, yeah. I got this. The connection.
They're all movie titles.
They're all movies. Yeah, let's make sense. Let's try this. Get Out. Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter. These are things I overheard at Burning Man. Get Out.
Out.
Well, that just leaves us with gel, felt tip, pen, and liquid.
Uh-oh.
Well, there's different types of pens. Let's see. They're types of eyeliners J.D. Vance owns. Let's look out. Well, that's all the time we have for tonight's show, Connections. We'll be right back with Jenna Ortega, everybody. Come on back. Hey, hey.